I would like to tell you about my research. Unfortunately, there is a lot to say about such a wide and interesting topic, and I only have 3 minutes to do so. Now, at this point, you probably realized that there was something wrong with this introduction. That's because the gestures I used completely contradicted the meaning I was trying to convey. And this can even happen without our realizing it. The 6 gestures on my slide, for example, they can get you into trouble in different parts of the world, despite your best intentions. And me, as the speaker, I found it really confusing saying and gesturing two completely different things. Try, for example, saying no, 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 and nodding at the same time. So not only are gestures connected to speech, but they very often complement it. They add meaning. So rather than saying, let's get a coffee, it makes much more sense to say, let's get a coffee, while we also show that we mean a big mug of coffee rather than a tiny espresso cup. So if there is this strong link between speech and gestures, what happens if a bilingual person gestures? Would they produce gestures that are linked to their first or second language? So this is what I would like to look at. In my research, I'll be comparing 90 speakers, a group of monolingual English speakers, monolingual Polish speakers, and bilingual Polish-English speakers, and their gestures. I will look at very specific linguistic examples, such as in English, when we talk about placing objects, we say, put away a mug, put away a newspaper, whereas in Polish, there are 2 different verbs, each having a different meaning. For example, in Polish, we'd say, postawić a mug, but we would say, położyć a newspaper. So each of them indicates that one would be standing, the other one would be laying. So the question is, will the bilingual person, even though they speak the English put, would they still indicate the meaning with their gestures? And now, does that mean that in the mind of a bilingual, are the two languages separate? Or at some level of proficiency, is there one completely different system created? Now, if gestures are a window to our mind, this gives a really good opportunity to look into how languages work in our minds and how speech works. So also, as I am sure that there are bilingual speakers in the audience, have a think and take a minute. Which language do you gesture in?